Hello and welcome to SideJoy. We're going to talk about new ways of detecting storms and tornadoes and how you can become a storm spotter. We have a high rate of false alarms for tornado detection because, well, the earth is round. And the United States has 148 NEXRAD or WSR 88D detectors spread across the United States. These are what we hear as Doppler radar. They send out microwave pulses and it reflects back to them, telling them what's around in the surrounding areas, much like a bat uses sonar. So it might hit birds or dust or something like that, but it's mainly looking for precipitation. And when it sends out the pulse and waits for the signal to come back, it's looking for three primary things. First, it's looking for how long did it take for that pulse to go out, hit the precipitation, and come back. That's going to tell you how far away the storm is. Second, we're going to look for something called reflectivity. When the microwaves are pulsed out, they're going to hit something and they're going to scatter much of the signal. But some of it's going to be reflected back, and the strength of that signal is going to tell the system, is it a light rain or is it heavy rain? Because the more precipitation there is, the more that's going to be reflected back. Or is it hail? Hail is going to be a lot better at reflecting these wavelengths than, let's say, rain. Third, we're going to look at the Doppler effect. You might have heard the Doppler effect explained to you in terms of sound. If a car is coming towards you, it's going to sound differently than it when it's going away. That's because when it's coming towards you, those sound waves are going to be compressed, and when it's going away, they're going to be expanded. The same thing is going to happen when we send out these microwave signals towards the precipitation. Those droplets that are moving away are going to allow the signal to expand, and those that are moving towards us are going to compress the signal. So you can tell if the system as a whole is moving, or you can tell if there's part of it that's moving away and part of it that's coming towards you. And you can see if it's spinning, which is obviously probably not a good thing. That's probably going to cause a tornado if it's going too fast. So what does the Earth's curvature have to do with any of this? Like we said before, there's only about 148 of these stations spread across the United States. So some of them are 100 or 200 miles apart from each other. And this is enough for the Earth's curvature to have an impact. And that means you're only going to see the top part of the system, and the curvature is going to eliminate some of the bottom parts of the system, where the tornado actually might be touching down. And this is why we have false alarms. So there's two ways that we can solve this. One is the new technology that the NSF has just released and talked about, which is called CASA. It's a lot smaller, and you can have a lot more of these little efficient ground stations. And it's kind of like putting a high-definition map. And there's links to the video in the description below, and it kind of shows you what pictures of our current data look like with Doppler radar and what it looks like when you have all these multiple ground stations. These systems are still in testing, and they're doing a pilot program down in Texas right now, but hopefully we can get more of these ground stations all over the place. There's more of us than there ever will be of ground stations, so we can help out. You can go to a Skywarn class near you. They have them all over the United States. There's links in the description below if you want to try and sign up for a free in-person class. There's also a link to one of their first ever Google Hangouts they did online. They teach you how to safely track storms, and you can also call in and say what you see. This is a picture from one of the Google Hangouts, and as you can see, the top part is what the radar saw, and the bottom part, where the actual tornado is where a storm spotter could see and call in and tell them what is actually occurring that they can't see on the radar. And I know we have viewers from all over the world, so I would love to hear about what your weather tracking systems are like, or if you guys have any public classes that you can take, please tell us in the comments below. Thanks for watching this episode of SideJoy. Tell me if you've ever been to a class that's kind of like Skywarn, or if you have an at-home weather station, or just any interesting weather-related stories that you might have. Thank you guys, and remember, keep exploring.